and thanks so much for watching Proactive New York. I'm Christine Corrado. With me right now is David Mazzo, CEO at Caladrius Biosciences. David, great to see you again. How are you?
Thank you, Christine. It's nice to see you. I'm doing very well. Thanks.
Good to hear, David. We last caught up in January of this year, almost a year ago, at the biotech showcase in San Francisco. This was really right before the coronavirus kind of devastated the world. Since then, you've managed to begin a study on a treatment for the coronavirus for induced lung damage. Can you tell us about this treatment that you've developed?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, this is really an interesting opportunity for us because, as you know, our company has a platform technology based on CD34 positive cells, which are anti-inflammatory and pro-angiogenic. So they're endothelial progenitors, and they, you know, create new capillaries in areas where there's been an insult. In the case of the coronavirus, you know, reports that started trickling out in February, March, and then became published in May and April show that this virus actually is a virus that can induce, I would say, damage to the microvasculature throughout the body. We've heard about kidney problems, people with sort of cognitive disorders because of the brain. But most of this is focused in the microvasculature or the endothelium of the lung, right? And so there are patients who seem to have recovered from the infection. That is, they clear the virus, they either come out of the hospital or get better at home. But for whatever reason, it seems that they suffer permanent damage to their lungs to the point that they can no longer oxygenate appropriately. And so they're considered hypoxic, and they use supplemental oxygen to be able to breathe. Our concept here is to take our endothelial progenitors and to formulate them in a way that they can be injected so that they can attack the lung, if you will, and replace those damaged tissue with the hope that these people will be able to either reduce their need or hopefully even eliminate their need for supplemental oxygen. So these are people who have suffered from the disease and have a chronic debilitation. It's not an acute treatment, and it's certainly not a vaccine. And we think that because we're focusing on that group of patients, we're actually in a leadership position here because many other companies have focused on the front end of the disease.
So I believe it was just last week that you announced that you were starting this trial. So what does the structure of the trial look like?
So the trial is actually just a proof of concept trial. It's being done right now entirely at NYU Langone in New York City because there were so many patients who have been infected in the tri-state area. The trial is looking for 10 to 12 people who have had a positive coronavirus diagnosis. They could have been intubated, you know, on a ventilator or not, but they clearly have been diagnosed as having cleared the virus, but have a chronic need for continued supplemental oxygen. And so they could be in the hospital or they can be outpatients. And that's really the main criteria, that their debilitation is not due to anything else than the virus contamination or infection. We're not looking for COPD patients or asthmatics per se, but people who have got this condition because of COVID-19. We'll be using our autologous cell therapy. So we take a sample of their progenitor cells from a blood sample. We prepare our therapy using their own CD34 cells, and they'll receive an intravenous injection of those cells, which will obviously circulate into the lungs. And hopefully, after, you know, a period of time, we'll be able to measure an improvement in their ability to self-oxygenate.
So you have already begun enrolling these patients?
Well, enrollment has begun. We haven't dosed the first patient yet, but all the sites of the NYU system, they're open and actively recruiting patients. And we hope to be able to, you know, treat the very first patients very soon.
And when could we expect some kind of results from this?
Well, typically after a patient receives this type of therapy, in other indications, we can start to see improvement as early as 3 months after the dose. These are single doses. So we'll be watching sort of constantly because we'll be monitoring oxygen levels in their blood on a relatively regular basis. But typically, this has a six-month primary endpoint. So we'll, you know, the results will be 6 months after, but we may see something sooner. And it's an open label trial, so we'll be able to talk about, you know, early results if they're apparent.
Good to hear. We'll look forward to hearing about those results. Besides this particular study, can you kind of provide us a brief update on your other product candidates?
Certainly, I'm happy to do so. We have a product candidate in Japan called Honedra, CLBS-12 formally, which is just finishing the recruitment and a registration trial for critical limb ischemia. We only have a handful of patients to go. COVID-19 in Japan has slowed down that recruitment as well, but we expect recruitment to be done by the end of this year or early next year, and then about a year from then, final results will be out. And because that product has a special designation in Japan, it's called a Sakigake designation, we're eligible for a rolling submission and a 6-month review time. So we hope to be submitting in early 22 and could have a product approved in Japan as early as mid to late 2022 with a commercial partner being identified to market that in that disease state. We're also about to start a phase 2B for CLBS-16 in coronary microvascular dysfunction. This is a tremendous opportunity here in the United States to treat a heart disease that's not very well known. It's a disease of the capillaries of the heart. So there's no large vessel disease, results in the same kind of poor prognosis for long-term mortality and also debilitating angina, et cetera. Tends to afflict women more than men, but not exclusively. And we had great phase 2A results that were reported last spring. And so we're starting a comprehensive phase 2B in a couple of months. And then, of course, we've already mentioned the ongoing 119 program for COVID-induced lung damage.
David, appreciate the update. Thanks so much.
Thank you for your interest, Christine. It's been a pleasure. Be well.